Appending data frames from multiple worksheets. Great question sent in this morning. Can a DF table be defined from several sheets having the same column titles but located on two or more sheets? Thanks. So in Power Query, we call this an append query. Here, let's just try right here. So what I have is I have three sheets. I have the sheet called 1 year, sheet called other year, and sheet called part of next year. So we'll come back here and Control-Alt-Shift-P to get into Python. Control-Shift-U to extend the formula bar. And I'm going to create a data frame called DF1 equal to, and just using my mouse, I click on 1 year, go up to the top, Control-Shift-Down, Control-Shift-Right, and then DF2 equals, using my mouse, I click on other year, go up to the top, Control-Shift-Down, Control-Shift-Right, third data frame. Now, wouldn't it be cool if we could just say, you know, hey, here's the whole list of sheets, go get them all. But that would require something like knowing how to do control down, or in VBA where we use, you know, start at A1 and do end XL down, XL right. Okay, so now we have these three data frames and I want to join them together. I'm going to create a list here of those, DF1, DF2, DF3. And then the magic is a function in pandas called concat. So pd for pandas.concat. And we're going to concat the frames. Now there's a whole bunch of other options here in concat, but right now, because all the columns are the same, we should just be good to go. Control enter. All right, it brings it back as a data frame. Let's do Control Alt Shift M to convert it to bring back the data. All right, what we see here, let's make column M a little bit wider so I can see those dates. I should have dates from 2020. And then moving on to 20. Oh, shoot, they bring in the headings. That's not what I want. Power Query would have been smart enough to get rid of those headings. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2621 and a half. How to drop the top row of a data frame. All right, three different choices here. ILOC, drop, or tail. Tail is the easiest one in this case. So I modified this. I kept the entire data frame one, so I get those headings. But then df2.tail minus one says get rid of the top row. And then df3.tail minus one, get rid of the top row. Control enter. We should have the same number of rows with the exception of the heading rows that occur right there after 1231. All right, there you go, a twofer. How to use concat to put multiple frames together, and then tail, which is kind of equivalent to the Excel drop function. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below.